Hello, and welcome back to another Plex-Earth 5D video. This time, we will show you how you can perform advanced terrain analysis through Plex-Earth 5D to gain more insights about a terrain for your designs. First up, make sure that our drawings to your reference settings have been defined. More information about this procedure can be found on our website. In order to perform a terrain analysis, there must be an existing terrain model to work on. If you do not have a terrain model, you can import one using Plex-Earth 5D. Let's quickly import a terrain for this island, which is our area of interest. First, click on the Import Terrain button from the Plex-Earth 5D ribbon. Next, choose your preferred terrain provider and specify the terrain cover area. We will do that in the drawing and by selecting this polyline that outlines our project area. After just a few seconds, a dynamic terrain is now available in our CAD workspace. Now, we can proceed in performing a terrain analysis. Plex-Earth 5D offers three types of terrain analysis. We can get a better visualization of the high elevation areas of the project or visualize slopes and directions of the terrain. The steps in conducting the three analyses will be similar. In this video, we will proceed in performing an elevation analysis. The units for this will be automatically assigned in accordance with the defined georeference settings, in this case, is in meters. Let's continue setting up the necessary parameters by clicking here. Specify how many ranges we want and assign the colors for the first and last range. We'll leave them as is for now. Click Create and the analysis will be swiftly calculated by the software, just like that. We will switch the visual style to realistic for better visualization of the analysis in this video. As the terrain imported is a dynamic Plex-Earth element, let's modify the analysis parameters to our liking as well. In the analysis drop-down box here, we can see certain values and colors. Each row represents an elevation range with its corresponding color. The left column refers to the minimum elevation value for each range, and the right one refers to the maximum elevation values. Notice that the colors after and before the first and last ranges, respectively, are automatically defined by the software to create a smoother, gradient-like transition between the two colors. These values and colors can be changed as preferred. Let's try changing the minimum and maximum values of this range, as well as the colors of some ranges, and observe how these will affect the current analysis. We'll type in this value for the minimum elevation of this range, and this value for the maximum elevation. Let's also choose a different color for these two ranges. This will be more useful when you have several ranges and you want each range to be more distinct and visibly distinguishable from each other. Let's apply the changes and observe the updated analysis. As you can see, there are visible gaps just before and after this range, as this value is greater than this and this value is less than this one. We can apply as many changes as we wish, and we can even switch to another analysis type. Simply set up the necessary parameters just like before, and if we go back to the elevation analysis conducted earlier, we can see that the data are retained and are instantly displayed on our workspace. As previously mentioned, the terrain analysis generated is a dynamic element unique to Plex-Earth. In order to utilize the analysis done offline or on computers with no Plex-Earth, it must be converted in a format that will be recognized by CAD in such cases. To do so, click the Insert button located in the terrain editor and select Analysis Object. Then, choose the display type. We'll choose 3D faces for this tutorial, and we will receive a notification that the CAD object has been inserted in the drawing. Once the drawing is saved, you can now share this with your colleagues and others. After performing the terrain analysis, you may also want to generate a table containing the necessary information about the analysis. In order to create a legend table, click the Insert button from the Terrain Editor palette and choose Legend Table. Specify a point in the drawing, which will be the top left corner point of the table. An elevation table has been generated as the current analysis defined in the Terrain Editor is this one. If we switch to a different analysis and insert a table, it will insert a different table correspondingly. With Plex-Earth 5D, designers can not only perform advanced terrain analysis in the simplest and most efficient way possible, but also gain valuable data of a terrain from the stunning visualization produced by our software. If you have any questions, feel free to send us an email to support@plexscape.com and our support team will be glad to assist. Thanks for watching and see you in another Plex-Earth video.